and another woman that could take your spot, man. If I wrote you a symphony.
Welcome back, beautiful people. So today we're going to be doing a crochet style, which is something that I haven't done in a very long time, using the Free Trust Wand Curl braiding hair. I have the fluffy wand curl, the ringlet wand curl, and the soft baby curl that I'll be using. So the first thing I did was I just cornrowed my hair straight back, nothing fancy. I connected the ones in the middle. And as you can see from the back, like, these are not pretty, but it doesn't really matter because this is going to be really big hair. If you were doing like a more sleek style, you want to braid a little bit better. So here's the soft baby curl. It's a smaller curl. The fluffy wand curl is definitely a little bit bigger and looser. And then the ringlet wand curl is like the perfect size curl, in my opinion. My thought was that I was going to use all three to give me this look that I was going for. But as I started working through, I figured out I didn't like the soft baby curl, so I decided not to use that. I just stuck with the ringlet wand curl and the fluffy wand curl. And honestly, in no rhyme or rhythm, I just kind of inserted the hair all throughout my head. There was no method to it. I would just separate the hair and I would grab a piece and insert it. And so I separated the fluffy wand curl into three pieces. And I separated the ringlet wand curl into two pieces. Now, you don't have to do this. I will warn you, if you separate the hair, it's going to make it more frizzy, which means your style may not last as long, or it'll get frizzy faster than it would if you just left the hair whole and inserted it. As you can also see, I have a little bit of leave out in the front, and this is completely optional. I only do this because I like to kind of cover the braids that are in the front. But with hair this big, it really isn't necessary. So again, you don't have to do this. You could just cornrow all of your hair straight back for a true protective style. And if you don't know how to crochet, this may not be the video for you. I didn't go into like extreme detail, but as you can see, once I get to the top of my head, you can kind of see how I insert the hook. I attach the hair to one end, close the hook, pull the hair through, and then kind of knot it. there are plenty of like techniques. There's the knotless crochet look. There's so many different techniques out there on how to crochet. This video just isn't one of those. If you don't know, or as you should know by now, I'm pretty lazy. I like quick, fast, just easy stuff. So nothing fancy here. I won't have like the knotless part or any of that. I'm just putting the hair in and keeping it moving.
How much you mean to me? What would you do if I told you you were beautiful? Would you date me on the regular?
Tell me, would you?
Well, baby, I've been around the world, but I ain't seen myself another girl
like you.
This ring here represents my heart, but there's just one thing I need from you.
Say I do.
And as I said before, for this style, I only ended up using one pack of each. I just separated the hair out to give me more. But if you decide not to separate the hair, you may want to get two packs. Two packs of each. And if you decide that you want to just do one type of curl, I would say three should be enough.
Because I can see us holding hands, walking on the beach, our toes in the sand. I can see us on the countryside, sitting on the grassland side by side. You could be my baby, let me make you my lady. Girl, you amaze me, ain't gotta do nothing crazy. See, all I want you to do is be my love.
So don't give away
my love.
So don't give away
my love.
So don't give away.
And another woman that could take your spot, my love.
So
so now that I've finished putting, I finished placing all the hair in my head. Initially, I was doing like a finger width apart, but then I felt like it wasn't big enough. So I decided to go back in, and I still had a lot of hair left. So I decided to just go back in and fill in any like holes or anywhere I could find with more hair just to make it more full. And again, this is up to you. If you don't like big hair, by all means, there's no need to try to use it all. Just, you know, again, when you're inserting the hair, try to place it about a finger width apart. So once I've done that, it's pretty big. The hair is pretty full. So I just kind of take the hair and pull it back so that I can lay down my my edges, the leave out that I had, and just kind of tuck the rest of the hair behind my ears. This is completely optional and probably not even necessary. I just do this because I like to cover the braids in the front. It makes it look a little more natural to me. All I want you to do is be my love. So don't give away my love. So don't give away my love. So don't give away. In the love of a woman that can take your spot, my love. So don't give away my love. So don't give away my love. So don't give away. In the love of a woman that can take your spot, my love. Voila, here's the result. I took some scissors and just kind of trimmed the hair into a shape. By no means am I a master at cutting, but just kind of evened it up a little bit, made it look like something. And this right here is me with the side part, but I also moved the hair into a middle part. But I felt like one side was a little more full than the other. So I've been sticking with the side part as I'm wearing the hair. And there you go. Get your selfies in, you know, put your makeup on or not. It's not necessary. But by all means, let me know what you guys think about this video. And please don't forget to like and subscribe. Bye.